Hello, universal and Islamic greetings. Peace be upon you. Assalamu alaikum.
I was going to leave Converted to Islam's video alone, but there is simply too much error to ignore it. You've heard his foundation.
For God is not subject to temptation to evil, and he himself tempts no one. So here we go, clear and cut, precise and definitive. God is not tempted into evil. We're talking about God. Can he be tempted into doing evil, sin, you know, wrongful deeds?
You've heard his realization.
Whether he sinned or not, that's not the issue.
But did you hear his confession? Converted to Islam is lamenting Jesus being tempted. Can you imagine Jesus, God, being tempted in every way like you and I were?
Christians believing Jesus is God and then knowing that the Bible says Jesus was tempted in every way that you and I were?
Converted to Islam is about to tell you the things that tempt him.
Can you imagine Jesus thinking about raping a woman or killing this old woman walking across the street, you know, cutting up these little children?
Oh my Lord, did we just hear that right?
Can you imagine Jesus thinking about raping a woman or killing this old woman walking across the street, you know, cutting up these little children?
Are you tempted by these same things as Muslims are, as Converted to Islam is? The more C2I talks, the more confused he sounds.
Regarding Jesus, for we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who has similarly been tested in every way, yet without sin. So here it's saying Jesus did not sin.
That is the whole point of the temptation. To prove Jesus is God and did not sin. And Converted to Islam contradicts himself even on this.
But one who has similarly been tested in every way, yet without sin. So here it's saying Jesus did not sin.
Hebrews 4:15. In all points tempted like as we are, yet without sin. C2I has just read Hebrews 4:15, which says, yet without sin. That means Jesus did not sin.
But one who has similarly been tested in every way, yet without sin. So here it's saying Jesus did not sin.
This means Jesus did not sin, for those of you not paying attention. And this is lost on C2I because he then says,
clearly Jesus is not God. He was tempted into evil.
The more C2I talks, the more confused he sounds.
We're talking about God. Can he be tempted into doing evil, sin, you know, wrongful deeds?
He says, we believe all prophets were sinless.
Because we believe all the prophets were sinless with regards to major sins.
With regards to major sins.
They were not sinless with regards to minor sins. And major sins are something like blasphemy and things like that.
Blasphemy, things like that.
Minor sins can be simply little mistakes.
Minor sins are like little mistakes. So are these major or minor sins to Muslims? Raping a woman. Killing an old woman. Cutting up little children. There are only two possibilities. These are minor sins, or these are major sins. If you call yourself Muslim, these cannot be minor sins, because prophets commit minor sins. And do you claim Muhammad did these things? Do you claim Jesus did these things? Therefore, they must be major sins, right? But remember, C2I states Jesus was tempted into evil, and the example he gives is these acts. If Jesus was tempted into evil, as C2I claims, then Jesus did these acts. But that would mean Jesus committed major sins, according to Islam. Or if Jesus did not do these sins, he was not tempted into the evil, as C2I accuses. See how confused C2I's position truly is? He cannot even define if these acts are major or minor sins in a framework consistent with Islam's dogma. So Jesus could not have been tempted into the evil of these acts and been a sinless prophet. Therefore, C2I's assertion that Jesus was tempted into evil is wrong, and worse, it is grossly wrong. And here is the clear understanding of this issue. You can be tempted and not be tempted. There are two definitions of the word tempted. Definition one, tempted means that an offer to an opportunity to commit sin is presented to you. Definition two of tempted means that you have an inclination, a desire, a wanting, a lusting, a predisposition to commit the sin if the offer is ever made. Satan tempted Jesus, but Jesus was not tempted. How can this be? The first use of the word tempted is definition one. The second use is definition two. Satan made the offer to Jesus, but Jesus was not drawn to it, enticed by it, tricked by it, seduced by it. He did not fall into it. Jesus did not commit the sin.
We're talking about God. Can he be tempted into doing evil, sin, wrongful deeds?
That is the whole point of the temptation. Jesus did not sin. Jesus is God and did not sin. And that, my friends, is the true nature of the temptation. If only those who call themselves Muslim would actually seek knowledge and understanding and truth and logic, they might know the truth, and the truth would set them free. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who C2I has proven is God. Amen.